base. Go ahead.
I was right. It was a secret Soviet project from the 50s called Carbonek. The laboratory was studying an ancient sword fragment, but some mysterious disaster brought the KGB down, and they erased it all from history. Almost.
There seems to be trouble below.
You got there right on time.
Or a little late. Those are Rotman's men attacking the Kazakhs.
Or Amanda's. Most likely she's the one behind this.
The lab is somehow connected to that military base, but we don't know how. If you can find the command center, we might get a better idea. Now, after the firefight dies down, you should try to...
Oh, come now, Zip. Waiting is for the patient. Or those without parachutes.
Well, I'd look around more, but go ahead and jump when you're ready.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. This is Video Games on Tour. I'm Franklocke. That's Frank and then Locke with me at the end. And today, we're going to be continuing our tour through Tomb Raider Legend. Right now, we're in Kazakhstan and it's snowing. Yeah. Awesome. And to start off this episode, we're going to go skydiving. Whee!
Now, Lara. Very nice, Lara. But you've just leapt from the frying pan into a nest of hornets.
Да, я знаю. Это глупо. Ugh. If you know Russian, that's a little bit of neat, a Easter egg for ya. Alright, let's do this. One, two, three. Yeah! How do you like that now, bitches? Ooh la la! You're dead, you're dead. You're dead too, I think. And you're dead as well. And you guys too. Alright. Area secure. Let's get out of here. Ah, crap. Get that son of a bitch. Ah, crap, 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 crap. Alright, got healed up. Let's do this. Okay, gonna take your rifle and your rifle and your rifle. And I'm gonna kill these sons of bitches. Whee! Alright, let's get in there. Yeah. Interesting. Alright. Let's get upstairs and cross the barred fences. Die, a potato! It only took 30 rounds to kill that son of a bitch. That's realism for you. Well, not really. Realistically, would have killed it in one shot if you know where to hit him. Uh oh. Die, 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 yeah. Got him. Man, that was too close. Alright. Got him too. Alright, let's go. Alright.
There's a keypad here, Zip. Do you know any good Kazakh codes offhand?
No, but I can hum along if you do the singing.
Funny. Alright, there should be some personnel around here. Like here.
Get down!
You are American!
British. And it looks like we share an enemy. Where's your command center?
Не отвечай ей! Что здесь нужно?
Погоди! Если она использует код исключаться, сработает тревога, и центр придет нам подмогу!
Да ты шо?
Мы здесь охраняем только снег и звериную мочу, или ты хочешь сам идти?
Through the gate! The code is K1879!
Спасибо. Пожелайте мне удачи.
Yeah, I can tell you right now that was some pretty accurate Russian, and that, no, that's not sarcasm. Except for, like, the first couple lines, it wasn't 100% word for word, but it is grammatically correct in terms of translation. Well, both in Russian, it was grammatically correct, and of course, translation, the English subtitles, was also grammatically correct. He gets the point across.
I don't know what the hell you guys were talking about, but I think the gate they mentioned is up ahead.
Ah, crap. Yeah. And you might be wondering, you know, in Kazakhstan, why were they speaking Russian and not, you know, Kazakhstani or whatever? Well, believe it or not, Kazakhstan was part of the Soviet Union. And during the early onset of the Cold War, and maybe even a bit before that, they tried to Russify pretty much any and every country within their sphere of influence, Kazakhstan being one of them. So that's why they speak Russian and have Russian characters. The more you know. Ah, shit. What the hell? God damn it. Okay, how many of these barrels do they got? Okay, they seem to be respawning. That's bullshit and you know it. And that was for constantly respawning all those explosive barrels. Now, you disappear and you think about what you've done. Ay, ay, ay. Alright, let's see.
Satellite photos. We got our own, there's nothing there.
The lab wouldn't be visible from above. We need maps. There it is.
Oof, that's a hike.
I'm not walking. There's a military transport train that runs past the lab. It looks like Amanda's boys are ahead of me. I'd better run.
Whoops. Satellite feed showing your train's about to roll. You better run. Fast.
Alright, let's get on that goddamn train before it leaves us. And we don't need tickets. Or at least I hope we don't. And yeah, you are actually going to be timed on getting there. So don't screw up. Also, this is one of the two levels that actually crash with next-gen content enabled. Which is why I'm playing this game without next-gen content. You're not going to be missing out too much, and considering that you can't even play the game without, you know, without it crashing with next-gen graphics, well, next-gen content, I should say, well, I think it's worth it. Yeah, one way or the other, the train will not, the gates will not open even if you get there early, but you do not want to be here when it starts leaving. You get on that bike and you start rolling. So long, suckers! And here's the reason why this is my favorite level of all time. It's got bike chases, well, train chasing, sci-fi, Russians, well, Kazakhstani, and pretty much everything else. It's the perfect package.
They're decoupling the cars.
And that music, you can hear it. Music is awesome. Alright, let's kick their asses. Oi, you! You're getting shot at for wearing short-sleeve shirt. You're not dressed for the occasion, and therefore you die. And you, I don't like you. You die too. Whee! Alright. Unfortunately, this isn't like, you know, the Nathan Drake trilogy, the first three, in which you get on a train and, you know, you kick some ass. Too bad, though. But then again, this was like 2006. So, actually, around the same time as the first Nathan Drake game was released. I think. I'm not sure. I can't think off the top of my head. I'm gonna have to do research on that one. Maybe get back to you later. And you! You too are wearing shorts to make sure that you die! I would make it in Soviet Russia joke, but this is Kazakhstan.
They let loose a few cars and they're blocking the tunnel. But I think I saw a path off to the right up ahead.
Well, they blocked the tunnel, so we have to take the scenic route. And I do mean scenic. Take a look. Whee! Yeah, Zip's with me on this one. Whoa. Out of the way, signs. I don't listen to you. I do what I want. Yeah, that's what you get for trying to warn me. We're playing as Lara Croft. You can't stop us. We own this place. This Arctic place. God damn it. Well, here's the train again. It's like they knew Lara was going to get on a bike, so they decided to get on the bikes themselves. Oh my god, now they got SUVs on the loose. You are cheating with SUVs. You die. And you are going to be die for association. There we go. I love my job. Alright. Alrighty. You die for using shotgun. And I die. It's okay, I'm back on my bike. I just have to go back here for a little bit. Alright, you suckers. Get ready to be owned. I think. Where is everyone? Oh, I see one. Way over there. I see two now. You, sir, have killed me once before. Therefore, you die. And you, sir, are using an SUV. And you're cheating. So you die. And you, I don't like you, so you die too. Alright. Got the med kits, gonna heal up. Alright, let's do this. You're trying to use the shotgun on me, you die. I will send you to the gulag, but gulag's too nice. Nice of a place for you. Right. Yeah, this level, this particular part is no different from the, what was it, Bolivia? That particular level, or some other place. Basically, when you are going back to that place where you had the flashback. I forget the name off the top of my head. I apologize. But it's no different from that. Different location, you know, different landscape, but and of course, the use of SUVs. No cheating with SUVs. You die. Supposedly. Well, my one gripe with the game is that it doesn't do automatic healing for you. Like in Metal Gear Solid. If you have rations equipped in that game and you go below a certain point, it automatically applies towards you. So, yeah. And I'm pretty sure these two just spawn out of nowhere. You teleported here. You die. Die, die, die. Okay, he's dead. And you two, sir, also die. In fact, anyone using SUVs in this area dies. Because I'm just that awesome. Oh my god. That was too funny. The guy got really distracted with my shooting, and therefore crashed into a goddamn tree. I'm too good for this place. I mean, come on, a guy died looking at me. Alright, got him. Let's get some med kits if we can. Guys, only got one left. find another tunnel. Whoop-dee-frickin-do. Alright. Let's heal. Here's a little bit a harder part to deal with. Steady, steady. Shut up, Zip. I'm trying to concentrate. Oh, sweet. I want to see that and put it on YouTube. But we'll do it later.
Damn. So now you're going to tell me you plan to do that?
Of course I did.
Of course you
careful.
Did.
Sheesh. Probably she didn't bang her head against, you know, the upper railings. But, whatever. Wait a minute. Who's driving the train? Oh, no, never mind. Okay. He was driving the train. Wait a minute, if he's shooting at me, then who the hell's driving? Oh, sweet Jesus. Oh, he did. And we're on fire. And there goes your jacket. And your... no thing of warmth, I guess. Uh oh. Get down! Alright. Ah, crap. Shoot it, shoot it! And you might want to get off the train. Thank you! Man, the service on the train was just god-awful. Even the driver was piss-poor. He was undisciplined. Because he was too busy shooting at me.
Phew! I feel like I just lived through a train wreck. How about you?
Undoubtedly.
Amanda's already inside, and the door's sealed.
So now what?
There's a vent on the wall to the right of the cargo door. The fan's running, she's got the power on.
How will you get in?
One way or another.
And Zip says he lived through a friggin' train wreck. I'm sorry, Buster, but that's exactly what we did. You were sitting behind the desk and a computer, watching. Most likely with popcorn. So, yeah. The hell with you. No hard feelings, no hard feelings. Okay. Oh, sweet Jesus. We got invited to the barbecue. Alright. And we shot out the fan. Great going.
It's getting colder.
That's bullshit. You're inside. Whatever. And yeah.
It looks as if you've stumbled into another tomb after all. I wonder what he's doing in here.
He's been trying to get out since the 50s, but he's frozen to death, the poor fellow. It's hardly a proper end for a scientist.
Yeah, no kidding. He's got something on his foot. Let's take a look.
The experiment's gone wrong. KGB sealed the facility. He tried to escape through the vents, but got trapped.
My God.
Well, at least with this tomb, we know what happened. Unlike in the other tombs, we have to interpret what might have gone wrong. Or what brought the end to their particular civilization. At least here, we know exactly what went wrong. Because thank God for apocalyptic journals.
It is much colder in here than it was outside.
Get down! Good thing we saw that before you stumbled right in. Down we go. Quick thinking, man. Alright, let's head this way. Jesus, how...
I'm not sure turning on the power was a good idea.
Looks like a few things in there won't be getting the juice they need.
The heater must be one of them.
Alright. Just how deep is this facility, anyway? And I wonder what they were working on. I sense some red alert technology in
the
works.
Look at the lights. She's only found the emergency power.
She came in through the main doors. I don't think she's been here. Looks like there's a generator on the other side of the room. She would have started it.
Alright, let's go here. Wait, hold on. I think I saw something over there. Hold on. Sneaking around.
It's a map of the facility.
Very retro. Probably looks like a carnival sideshow when the power's on.
Yeah, that's what he was talking about. Don't worry. He was talking about the wall. Or she wasn't, or whoever wasn't. Whatever. Alright, another power orb or some shit. Alright. Let's get up here. Even modern facilities are built like tombs, and that's kind of sad. I mean, when you think about it. Because they're easily traversable by our dear friend Lara Croft. Alright, we got the juice. Literally.
That should do it.
Alright.
There you go.
See, without the grappling hook, how in the hell did the engineers or whoever start up the engine? Whatever. Alright, let's take a look.
You have to admire this map's simplicity.
And what do you know? It looks just like a carnival sideshow.
Now, before you ask, no, I cannot read Russian. I can only speak and understand it. Even though Russian was my first language, I didn't exactly learn it for too long. I stopped really learning it when I was seven, since the age of seven. And then I had to take ESL and all that other good stuff, so no. I can speak to you and understand you if you're speaking to me in Russian, but don't expect me to read or write. Not yet, anyway.
I wonder if that's toxic.
I guess it's coolant, but who knows what kind of lethal crap the Soviets were using.
I'd rather not find out firsthand.
It's Nova 6. A biochemical weapon. I don't know. That's my impression of Gary Oldman. I'm sorry. I should probably never do that again, because I like the guy too much. And the game, too. The first and second, the third, nah. Story-wise, I understand it now, what they were trying to do, but it doesn't excuse the complete BS that was going on. Anyway. Uh-oh. Alright. Ah, goddamn camera. I'm sorry. Camera still sucks in this game. Ah, shit.
God, friends!
Ah, damn it, Lara.
It's charged.
Get down. Kind of reminds me of Metro 2033 and its sequel, I forget what it's called. Last Light, I think it was? I could be wrong. I apologize. I'm so enamored by this game. It's not even funny.
Hey, that's her!
Amanda?
Damn it, Lara, I'm busy.
I see you've changed your look. That was you in Bolivia, then. With Rutland.
I've been all over, and I'm going to places you can't conceive of. You're the one being left behind this time. Sorry.
I'm sorry, Amanda. If I'd known that you were alive, I swear I would have done everything I could to save you.
Please. I got over that a long time ago. You know what really used to bug me, though? When I got out and saw that you left without even trying to... What is it archaeologists do? Oh, right. Dig.
We'd thought of it as a memorial.
Whatever. Don't let her follow me.
What an ungrateful bitch.
Check out the big gun thing. How spaced out is that? Maybe it'll help you.
And second, that grenade should not have been able to destroy the platform. I don't care how old it was. A fragmentation grenade does not have that kind of explosive. But obviously I'm going to forgive them because, well, it's a video game and I don't, you know, I shouldn't be bothered too much by it.
Did you see that?
Yeah. Getting crazy interference on the video, too. I'd say what we have here is one of Nikola Tesla's toroidal coil guns. Except that would be impossible.
You may be right. It doesn't seem to work very well.
Well, they'd theoretically need a lot of power, like from that Tesla tower across the way. If you could get that Tesla tower fired up, wow, I never thought I'd get to say that.
We might be able to bridge the gap somehow.
So, Red Alert technology from Command & Conquer is what you're saying. Alright, I'll bite. I've seen greater shit. Yeah, but the man is one ungrateful jerk. Seriously. Come on. I wouldn't be that pissed. I'd be like, hey guys. Surprise. Oh, this guy thought he could use a riot shooter on me. Well, we'll see about that. Bullet time, bitch.
Don't get hit by any of those electrical arcs.
I thought you said it wasn't running.
That's just the ambient discharge. The tower was on, you'd know it.
And if I were the energy source, where would I be?
Up top.
You know, Matt Damon was left behind and they thought he was dead. And he was never angry about it. He was like, hey guys, surprise. Now, can you like pick me up or something? You know, take me out to the pizzeria by 5? Please? Thanks? Okay, good job. I mean, come on, how many times was Matt Damon left behind and had to be rescued? Or just had to be rescued, period. He never gave no smack talk about that. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna wait for that electrical discharge to pass by. Then we're gonna go. Alright. Well, that went well. Sweet Jesus. But yeah, I mean, come on. How many times did Matt Damon have to be saved? And he wasn't angry. He didn't, you know, summon spirits to kill Lara Croft or Tom Hanks or pretty much anyone and everyone, you know, in The Martian. Sheesh. That lady needs to chill. Like, I don't know. Netflix and chill, I guess. I'm probably using that wrong, and I apologize. What the hell? God damn! She was supposed to catch that. How did she not? Ah, son of a bitch. Alright. Let's try this again from the top. Well, from the bottom. By the numbers. Alright. Swinging. Okay, enough of that. Alright. Gonna wait for that. There you go. Shit.
Careful!
Are you kidding me? She didn't catch that either? Such bullshit. No, that's total bullshit right there. Alright, let's try this again. From the bottom to the top. Uh Ah, sweet Jesus. Alright. Whoops, camera's clipping right through it. Alright. There we go. Now don't screw up here because I'd be really pissed. Alright.
Another scientist. No warmth for him up here either. They funneled Tesla energy into the artifact, and there was an enormous discharge of some sort. The KGB shut down the operation, removed the core, sealed off the lab in sections, and left behind those scientists who weren't forcibly removed.
A peculiar turn of events.
That's bullshit. Why would you waste such good manpower? You know, just because something went wrong. Also, if I remember correctly, there is a trinket over here, or was supposed to be. I already collected it.
Can the tower be powered up from here?
Not without the core. Looks like it's not here. I guess that's what those tracks in the floor are for.
Alright, let's go get that core.
What are those hanging cords and sockets?
Decoupled high current cables. You're lucky they're off, or you'd be standing in the middle of a painful light parade.
Well, that's one way to describe it. Alright. So yeah, apparently the Russians, the Soviets, whoever, got their hands on a fragment, sword fragment, and were decided to, you know, be Soviets, and, well, I'm sure you know the story.
Okay, there's a core up ahead.
Hear that?
Knock, knock, motherfucker! Svedanya, Duraki, Sabaka.
Doesn't look like it has a charge, but you might be able to juice it from the control room above you.
Alright. Let's bring this thing a little bit closer.
There's heavy debris on the tracks. I don't see how I can move it.
It doesn't matter if the core doesn't have power. Get it charged, and then we can deal with that.
Well, that's a problem that takes care of itself. I mean, we are dealing with Tesla tech.
Hello, Lara.
What the? How the hell did you get on this channel?
Hush, Sip. She must have taken a headset while she was rearranging your office.
You're so smart, Lara. Do you know why the Soviets called their project Carbonek?
It's the castle where Lancelot sought the Holy Grail. Not the first connection to Arthurian myth I've come across.
Myth, she calls it. A limited word for a limited perspective. You were always such the scientist. You're probably right at home with all these Tesla contraptions, aren't you?
As much as anyone, I suppose.
The Russians activated a power in the artifact that literal minds can't handle, and it destroyed them. So don't push the wrong buttons.
You'd better not either.
But I know which ones are the right ones.
You've learned to read Russian since I last saw you, Amanda.
She hung up. What the hell was that about?
She's having difficulty obtaining the sword fragment, and she doesn't want to blow everything up in the process.
Maybe you should have told her what she wanted to know.
Why the hell would you tell an enemy anything, really? I swear to God, if I meet this lady, I'm kicking her ass.
Another unlucky scientist.
Let's see what he's got to say.
He writes that at least a dozen of his colleagues were killed in the experiment. The artifact converted the Tesla voltage into something else. A wave of concussive force of some kind.
That's familiar enough. So why were they shut down?
They refused to repeat the experiment, and when the KGB tried to persuade them otherwise, it got nasty.
So, infighting. You know, this game kind of reminds me of another game called, I think it's called Cryostasis. It's a Russian-made game taking place in the 60s, and you get on this, you know... Hold on. Something's happening.
Now that's how you do it!
Is that supposed to stop at some point?
It's not charged all the way. I don't know what's wrong.
How am I supposed to move it if I can't touch it?
The cable on your grapple is insulated.
Right.
Well, that's good to know, I guess. But yeah, Cryostasis, I think, was the name. I could be wrong. If you guys know it, let me know in the comments. Alright.
Haha! Okay, that's how it works.
Yeah, we might want to stay off the track for the time being. Alright, let's get this baby across the room.
What's happened here?
Weird. The core must have powered these cables somehow. Those rails are one of the most convenient conductors around.
Timing is everything. Alright. Get that one moving. Alright. Hold on, let's get a little bit closer so we'll have more time to move. Wait for it. Alright. Not anymore. I mean, that's through it. Whatever.
Cool. Now all you have to do is get the panel out of the way, and we're in business.
Alright, there it goes. Wow. This is totally Red Alert technology. Well, for the Soviets, anyway. Alright. Ooh, what's this?
It's a shield. 10th or 11th century. Probably recovered with the piece we're looking for. It resembles Lancelot's crest, doesn't it?
It would if the banner had existed.
Oh, what's this now? It looks like a map. Have a good look and see what you can make of it.
What do you think it's for?
Maybe our knight needed help finding his way home. Or perhaps this piece wasn't all he had.
You think he stashed more of the sword somewhere?
Possibly. But the map is useless without a reference point.
I'll work on it. Going offline.
Splendid.
Alright. And we got another dead guy.
Frozen to death, like the others.
Let's see what he's got to say.
A number of minor relics were recovered along with the artifact. But poor fellow couldn't find anyone to help him stumble.
I empathize. Why their lack of interest?
They were too contemporary for serious study. It seems they date from as recently as the first millennium.
I'm sorry, but am I missing something? How old exactly is this artifact we're looking for?
Older than you'd think.
Yeah, apparently the sword that we're looking for predates that of King Arthur myth. Ah, crap. Riot shields.
I don't think I've ever been happier! Show me what it can do!
Whoops. Got that guy. Got that guy. Ah, it's like the gravity gun! Hold on. Ah, son of a bitch. Aw, oh, come on! Ah, whatever, let's get this thing across. Well, he can't shoot for shit, that's nice. No, 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 god damn it! Ah, shit! Idiot! The glupa! It's nice at the... Shut. Alright. Let's try this again. All right. Yeah, dance for me, boy. Dance. All right, screw this. Please don't fall. Please don't fall. Okay, thank God. Let's move on. That'll help. Oh, that works. That just randomly broke.
Stay back.
Or stay down. That always works. Shit. Steady breaths, steady breaths. And don't die. I swear to God. Wow. Oh, hey.
Amanda. I'm sorry for what happened. But we can still work together.
There is no we, Lara. There never was. It was just me down there. Me and this. Do you remember it? I touched it, and it touched me back.
Ew.
I didn't think that was a good thing.
I tamed it then, and made it my own.
What the hell? Ah, shit. Call the Ghostbusters.
A little friendlier than it was in Paraiso, isn't it? I taught it how to fetch.
You're mad! It killed our friends, Amanda, and it almost killed us!
And it saved my life once I mastered it. It's all about a broader perception. I'd stay away from it if I were you, though. It'd still be able to touch you.
Ah, shit. Call the Ghostbusters. That's exactly what we need.
Lara. I don't control it.
Hold on. Alright, to defeat this boss, it's, well, be absolutely careful. Alright, first, what you got to do is release the clamps. And you can find these release valves or levers with these English language high voltage signs. Well, that's interesting. Whoa! Yeah, and this guy lays down mines that explode by themselves. Alright, one more clamp, let's take care of it. Seriously, we need the Ghostbusters. Alright, and that's the last one. Oh,
there
you're not...
The sword fragment, clamped overhead.
Zip, what do I need to do to get it out of there?
You're not supposed to fight this creature. If anything, this is what you're supposed to do. Alright, that's all we got for today, folks. I'm Franklocke. That's Frank of Enlock. We need the end. Have some chips and salsa, baby.
As the crow drives.
Well then, let's see who can get there first.